Now I'm joined now by John Bramnick, who is the Assembly Republican leader. Assemblyman Bramnick, welcome to New Jersey 101.5. How you doing, John?
Thanks for being with you, Bill.
Yeah, you bet. So what do you think about this?
Well, every person in the state now owes $52,000. Now, how did this happen? Look, we know Republicans and Democrats for the last 20 years have made mistakes in the legislature. Remember, all of the spending comes out of legislature. You know, people may want to criticize Chris Christie, but he's not in charge of spending. That's the legislature. Now, for the past 13 years, the Democrats have controlled the legislature. I actually like Steve Sweeney, and I like Vinnie Prieto. But when management fails, that's when you change management. It's not personal. People want to say, oh, John Bramnick's partisan. It's not partisan. For 13 years, they've raised the taxes 115 times. Every time I say that, they say, well, we need more money. We should raise more taxes. Look, people are leaving this state in droves. The surveys say people, as soon as they have an opportunity, they're going to go. This November, you can vote for a new assembly leadership by voting for a Republican candidate. And once again, look, this is not about partisanship. It's about a record. Not only that, I've asked for a debate. No one on the Democratic side will show up for a debate. I don't blame them.
So,
I won't show up either.
Well, let me ask you this, though. So what is the real solution, though? I mean, well, it's easy to say the Democrats didn't do it and the Republicans will do better, but what?
Most of the debt has to do with unfunded pension liabilities and increased cost of health care. Now, we had a bipartisan panel that said we had to reduce some of the health care benefit plans from these so-called platinum plans to a lesser plan. Mm-hmm. Now, the Democrats in the legislature, they don't want to move on any more reforms. They said, we've done the reforms. Well, the problem is we're billions of dollars in debt. All I'm saying is you have to start to discuss these reforms, because I don't care if you have a Democrat or Republican governor. At some point, you're going to have to face the music. Otherwise, this debt will continue to explode.
So let me ask you, John. Now, Governor Scott Walker just dropped out of the presidential race, but he is best known for guiding Wisconsin from in a blue state from incredible debt, billions of dollars, to hundreds of millions of dollars in surpluses after his first budget that passed after they passed something called Act 10, which eliminated collective bargaining effectively for teachers unions and public workers unions. And that allowed the local municipalities to negotiate their health benefits, to negotiate for the pensions. It turned Wisconsin around. Is there anyone in New Jersey willing to propose something that is so drastic but actually might work?
I don't think collective bargaining in and of itself is a bad thing. What the legislature can do, we can continue the reforms that we started. And if you recall, when Chris Christie first came here, the Democrats were cooperative, and we started to make those reforms. But no more reforms are permitted by the Democratic leadership. It's not about collective bargaining. The state legislature can move right now on continuing a discussion on reforms with this excessive debt. And we can be fair to people in the system by saying new people in the system have a different deal. They won't even accept that kind of a new system.
So you're saying so that's a specific solution. Phase out the folks that are coming in new.
But start to talk about reforms with respect to new people in the system. And if new people in the system accept that, fine. But there won't be any. As I understand it, they're done with reforms, and therefore we're piled with debt.
You know, I have to tell you, though, all due respect, John, we're friends. I think you make a lot of sense. But I think the time has passed for these small incremental reforms. It reminds me of the legend of the Gordian Knot and Alexander the Great when faced with But here's the question, though. You've got $110 billion in future liabilities that are unfunded and $85 billion in debt. To me, I don't see anything more than Alexander the Great cutting the Gordian Knot. Just cut it and end it and take away the power for these guys to negotiate statewide. How come the Republicans don't have a solution to empower the local communities?
Let me tell you, we have a lot of solutions, but the way the legislature works, unless the speaker posts those solutions, nobody can vote on. But Tom Byrne, who's a Democrat who led this pension commission, has laid out a plan that has been unacceptable by the Democratic leadership.
That's a shame, because Tom is, I know Tom, he's a good guy. And, you know, there has to be some bipartisan discussion on this. But I can't help but feel we are so far down the road. It feels unrecoverable.
We can fix this state. incredible location, incredible people. You know, it's a great place. Yeah. We can fix it. But you can't allow the same leadership to stay there year after year and expect to have some change.
All right. Strong points from Assemblyman John Bramnick. John, thanks for joining me on New Jersey 101.5.